Well, hello and welcome to what amounts to football heaven. It doesn't get a whole lot better than this. The conditions utopian, the sun is high in the sky. It's a truly beautiful afternoon, and the crowd reflect that. Their faces hopeful, their smiles beaming. Levels of excitement and expectation are soaring, and you get the feeling that this could be a very special occasion indeed. Nobody in this atmosphere can hide from the truth about how much this game matters. The scene overflows with colour and passion. As you can see, we've already started here. So, Jim, who would you identify as the key man in this fixture?
The fellow you're looking at, Peter, Ashraf Hakimi. I think one of the better offensive fullbacks anywhere in the world. He's very much the modern fullback. He was a winger, moved a little bit deeper, but he still has that passion to get forward. And we know it's backed up by a great engine, and occasionally an eye for goal.
Yes, he'd be my pick too. It's going to be all about how they get the best out of him.
Are getting there. This is really high.
And constantly after the ball, aren't they?
Yeah, I think they're weighing up their options to see how long they can sustain this and suppress those wide opposition players.
Ricardo. Now the breakaway. Oh, it's a nice idea, but the execution was lacking. Even some of the opposing fans are clapping that. You just have to appreciate it.
Yeah, and it's not a surprise to see him elect to shoot from there, considering how much movement can be generated on the ball. Great hit.
Saint-Germain get themselves into the lead.
Yeah, this is also a chance to see what happens to their level of concentration from here.
Mbappe. Ferry. And we hit half-time. So the end of the first half, both teams have had their moments. There's been no shortage of talking points, but there has been just one goal, and that is the state of it at the break. 1-0.
It's a dressing room that needs rousing at half-time, because in truth, they've not really been at it so far.
If the pep talk works, we may see a very different side second half. We need to.
Already up and running for the second half.
Montpellier need to get the balance right to sort this out. Ambition must be complemented by just the right amount of caution, and I think the more experienced players can oversee that.
And it's Dembele.
He's got away with one there.
You lucky boy, you lucky, lucky boy. Giving the ball away like that is usually punished.
Chance to counter.
Now it's Kasri.
The referee's awarded a free kick.
Exactly the approach they have to take now, Peter.
They're coming again and again.
You know, the interest value in this game might just take off from here.
Out for a throw.
Dembele. Played out to the left flank.
No messing about, just bludgeoned away. Well, they've got it back in a hurry. Crossed in again. Now the finish! Really well taken goal. And this is getting better and better.
The keeper deserves some sympathy there. He may not have seen that until too late.
Paris Saint Germain
have a couple of goals without reply. It's 2-0.
Sends it forward. Marquinhos cuts out the pass. Vitinha.
Montpellier are certainly now looking like a sorry lot. They haven't got a proper defence or attack, for that matter.
Paris Saint-Germain are making a change now.
I think you have to admire his willingness to keep plugging away, but the manager has done him a big favour, I think, by taking him off. You know, he was looking very, very leggy.
Plays it from a quarterback position. Oh, that's a key interception.
Vitinha, spread out to the left.
Gets away from his opponent.
The cross comes in.
Oh, that's a cracking ball. Too quick for defence and keeper.
And that is that.